Thank you. I'll say my disclaimer now, that video started about 2 minutes early. So all that, you know, frantic tango dancing was, we were floating in the ether up here, but that's all right.
Good photographs in any case. Now I have to dive into the depths. This will be interesting.
So one of the, one of my goals, I guess you'd say, with all the stuff with the videos and also doing it live is to kind of push myself and the group, you know, kind of up to another level of, we're already, especially these guys, they're already great performers. I'm not going to say of performance, but of kind of, I don't know, putting more demands on us in terms of, and especially the whole integrating the video thing is kind of an extra layer. And plus, in this particular piece, I'm using kind of using effects and getting a little crazy. And this piece, also, I collected photographs, seems like for months, a couple of years ago, just wandering around town looking for strange symmetrical objects and situations, which many of which found their way into this piece. So I guess I better stop talking and just do it. This is Unexpected Symmetries.
Thank you. Thank you.
It's a little like playing a bass on a tightrope. Something very relaxing. One of my favorite composers, I think also of the band, we do a lot of his material, and we're going to do a kind of a classic Ellington tune now, Drop Me Off in Harlem. It's a classic, but not too many people know it. It's kind of a cool thing. One, two, one, two, three.
Thank you. Holy cow.
I'd like to do a song now by Milton Nascimento, the famous Brazilian composer. And I don't know, I just love this piece. It's I don't know what this would be like, but I was going to say it reminds me of floating down the Amazon in an inner tube. Maybe someday I'll find out, right? Thank you.
Michael Levin. All right. Somebody on the way in asked me if we're going to do Piazzolla, so here we go. This features James. Libertango. Thank you. James Sanders. Michael Levin. Leandro Lopez Varady. Sarah Allen. Doug Lofstrom will be back in a minute.
Doug Lofstrom and the New Quartet. Give it up. How cool is this? We'll be back after a short break. The bar is now open. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for a wonderful set, and we'll be back with a little conversation and more music. Thank you. I am so happy to have Doug Lofstrom here, and we have been talking about this for a long time.
I worked on getting this show for about 2 years, maybe more, 2.5 to 3 years even.
Well, and the truth is, we were talking about, and this for our radio audience, this is going to, they're not going to care because they can't see it, of course. But I was particularly interested in doing something where we could do some combined media, where we had the live music and the films, which I think are brilliant and wonderful and add such a nice dimension
Thank
to the
you.
Evening. And we didn't install our projection system till last summer, so so we couldn't. And then the fall was kind of got a little problematic for us, so we're glad to do it in the spring. So how great is this?
This is great.
So
and thank you all for being here.
Well, I have a question. I just got to get out of the way, and I think you're probably going to know where I'm going. But the New Quartet has got 5 people in it, and now you're going to add another one to the second set. So just get this out of the way.
Steve, it's a really simple thing.
Okay, good.
But you guys don't know this. I started this group in 2001. That's a long time ago.
Wow.
Yes.
That's before I was born.
That's before. No, Steve was 8 years old. I was 15. No. Anyway, the band for the first year the band was a quartet, with no drums. And then It was these guys.
Same four.
These three and me and no drums.
Got it.
And then after a while, I couldn't say exactly when this happened, but it was within a year or two, we started doing more material that absolutely, absolutely needed drums.
Uh-huh.
And so we spent about a year or two, you know, who knows how long these times are.
Right.
With Sarah as special guest.
I see.
And then she kind of morphed into the group. By the time we did a second CD, she had morphed into the group.
Got it.
So then it was a quintet, but I didn't want to change the name because that's the kind of a guy.
You already had the business cards.
Well, yeah. No, I already had promo, you know, printed promo and stuff, yes. But I don't know. I like the name.
I think it's great. I think it's really
and
great.
So tonight we're adding a sixth member who you will meet in a moment playing a wonderful solo piece that I wrote with video, Laura Hamm. But that's another story for in a few minutes.
Okay. I don't know if any of you are signed up for our newsletter. Well, some of you have just signed up for our newsletter, but I did mention that tonight. One of the things that you're going to experience is the world's largest quartet.
That's right.
Here we go.
Unapologetically.
Uh-huh. So this group, are you all, I guess maybe the answer is obvious, but it seems as if you are all sort of like mind in the sense that you are kind of connoisseurs of music from lots of different genres.
That's exactly right. We actually had a different violin player for not long, a couple of rehearsals.
Uh-huh.
Somebody I like playing with a lot, but she just couldn't she couldn't make a commitment.
Uh-huh.
And she gave me James's number, which James I did not know.
Uh-huh.
I called James, and God bless him, he was excited, like, okay, I want to do this, and I'll see you. And so we set up a rehearsal at Columbia College downtown, and James and Leandro and I showed up, and Michael, who's always like an hour and a half early for everything, was nowhere to be seen.
Huh.
And I don't know how long it took, but within, you know, maybe half an hour, we get I probably got a phone call from him that said he was stuck on the Eisenhower because it had flooded.
Oh, wow.
And so, but he said, I'm coming. I'll be there. So I said, well, let's play some stuff, just the trio. And James said, let's play Nature Boy.
Nature Boy?
Yeah. And we played Nature Boy. Man, we burned it. Huh. It was fabulous. And so then it was not that arrangement, obviously, but then I turned around and I kind of wrote that arrangement into that piece.
Mm-hmm. And so there were other stuff like that. And Leandro, I was always excited to play with because he had just arrived from Argentina. And I was, at that time especially, still somewhat, but at that time I was totally, totally gaga over Piazzolla's mm-hmm, music. Mm-hmm. And I knew Leandro was kind of, into that, but also he kind of had the whole feel for it. And so, yes. And the other thing is, you can probably tell, everybody here, the first requirement is you have to read like a hawk.
Yeah.
Because
this
you know,
is tough stuff.
Yep. Some of it is tough, and almost everything has a written chart. Although we do, as you see, also we do plenty of improv.
Yes.
And and then Michael, you know, I've been friends with Michael for 40 years since we were both six.
Wow.
And
I wonder where that was going.
But he and I played I had him on another thing that I did at Columbia College the previous year, and I had so much fun performing my music with really good players. I said, oh, and he and I went out to lunch. I said, I have to do a band that's at this level, and you know, would you like to be in it? And he immediately said yes. And that's kind of how it happened. But the other thing that, and I guess this is kind of on me, but I think it's probably true of everybody in the group. My first criterion for picking a song for this group is I have to be like obsessed with it. Mm-hmm. Either I found it, wherever I found, we're going to do a couple of film, you know, pieces from film scores in this set. And, you know, you hear something in a film, it's like, wow.
Yeah.
And so I'm not shy about like either buying the CD or running off from the soundtrack and, you know, sitting down and transcribing it and making my own version of it, which we've done with a couple of things tonight. And so there's other stuff like that, too. And I also, we're not doing a lot of our quote-unquote classical music material tonight, but we have plenty of, like, almost like straight classical stuff in the book.
Well, it's really great to hear. First of all, it's not an uncommon refrain when I have these conversations with people to hear, well, we got together because I was friends with this guy and I was friends with her, and then these three people I just really enjoyed being with. It almost starts with a chemistry of we all really like each other.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I mean, the musical acumen is sort of of course, a given. But then once you know, there's all manner of great drummers in the world, but there's only one, Sarah Allen.
That's right.
You know. You know what I'm saying? You know, and you can say that about each of these people. They're they're all unique individuals, and when you have a chemistry of friendship between them, then you find, you know, open hearts and open minds and open ears to try anything. And I love that you're just sort of musically, anything's on the table. That's what sort of jumps out at me, is that you guys kind of will tackle anything that sort of appeals to you.
That's right. That's kind of been my mission, one of my missions for the last 20 years or so, and it's focused on this band, but I do other stuff too. In fact, in 2 weeks, on the 14th, I have a gig at Peabody Estate in Oak Brook.
Oh, wow.
It's a place where, you know, people have weddings, you know.
Uh-huh, yeah.
With a little chamber orchestra that I put together with former students and a few colleagues, and performing a lot of my music and other stuff too. Actually, a couple of these things that we're doing tonight, but with strings and extra woodwinds and stuff.
Wonderful.
So I actually I have cards for those. I'll put them out.
Please do. I have one more really quick question, and then I would love to just get back to some more music.
Sounds good.
I love it so much. You started making these films just because, or the idea of
the first idea was I made two or three things that were very short that were like promotional videos for the band. And then I made a longer one based on one of our songs from the first CD. And I used flower, really beautiful, kind of almost portrait quality flower photos from the same photographer I mentioned, Paolo De Andrea. Mm-hmm. And then I had some of my own quick and dirty pictures of, like, you know, flowering apple trees and stuff like that. And that was the first one of those that I did. And the second one we're actually doing tonight, which is based on Irish music. And that one I actually found some, God bless this person, whoever it was, and this was already like over 10 years ago, went to Ireland. He shot like 250 beautiful photographs, and he put them all anonymously on like PD Photo or one of these.
Wow.
Which at that time there were not too many of those, mm-hmm, mm-hmm, those public domain photo sites. But, and you know, they say you can use this, you know, you can use this commercially, you can do this, you can that. So I said, okay, I'll use this music and I'll make a video about Ireland, and we'll see it tonight. Now, I wish I'd been in Ireland and taken those pictures, but I didn't.
Right, right.
I'll admit that ahead. But most of these other videos have my photographs and or video. This first one is a mix of photographs and video. And it's just, I don't know. You know what happens? The third piece in this set, I'll say this because you asked me about the videos. I don't know when this was, 4 or 5 years ago. And at that time, I was still full-time at Columbia College. I've since retired. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much. I am as happy as a clam to be. And some of you know this. I do my own thing, and money appears in my bank account every month.
That is
incredible. That amazing or
that
what?
Incredible.
God bless America, right? If you know, some people are pissed off about that, but too bad. So I was walking to work early in the morning, and I a lot of times I would walk. I almost always take Metro, and I would walk down Canal Street to Harrison or something. You know, it doesn't really matter. But I was walking down Canal Street, and Canal is where it goes under the Eisenhower Expressway. Is where there's a wide sidewalk on the east side and a very narrow sidewalk on the west side. I almost always take the wide one, but this time, for whatever reason, I ended up on the west side on the 2-foot-wide sidewalk, and I'm just walking along, and it's a nice sunny day, maybe in spring, I don't remember what time of the year. I walk out the south side of the viaduct, and I look at the walls of this underpass, and they're like on fire. It's fabulous. Hmm. It's like the entire wall is like an art exhibit. You'll see it in this video. So I went back a couple of weeks later with Paolo D'Andrea, also known as Ruben. I knew him as Ruben for 30 years. Then he wanted to be a photographer, so he changed his name. But in any case, we went back. We each took photographs. At that time, I was only taking photographs with my phone, but God bless the iPhone. It takes pretty good photographs. Mm-hmm. And then once we had done that, I guess in some cases this is me walking to school, but you know, I went back and did my own kind of iPhone photo shoots 2 or 3 more times. You won't believe this is all in one location, downtown, and what it really is, I think, this piece, which I'm plugging this piece, so it's coming up in this set though, that it's kind of a portrait of time. It's a portrait of benign neglect, you know, like, and at some point, God, who knows whose idea this was, we pay these people to do this. Somebody said, well, that wall looks a little funky. Let's put stucco on it. So some of these walls had stucco, which, of course, had totally disintegrated, and anywhere there was metal, steel or iron or, you know, so you'll see it. It's sort of cool. But that video forced me to, like, make it. Huh. You know, I was just like, I got to do something. And I'd been making a few of these videos, so I thought now's the time. And that one sort of got me on a roll. And the solo bass thing that I did the first set is kind of in the same vein, you know?
Yeah.
And some of these videos will actually have video in them, this first one that Laura plays for. But so that's kind of the story of the videos. I don't know. I'm just a crazy guy that's obsessed. I find things, I have to do them. And since money appears in my bank account every month, I can get away with it. If, you know, 30 years ago, I probably couldn't.
That's magic.
Thank you.
Well, it really is all beautiful, and we're thrilled you're here and sharing it with us. So thank you. Thank you. And I know you've got a special guest coming, so I'm going to leave the stage.
Shall I introduce her?
I'll let you introduce
her. Okay.
Laura. Okay, and thank you. Thank you all.
one of my dear friends and a unbelievably fabulous flautist, Laura Hamm. I should have ducked that thing. I should have got it off there. That was the flute player who played it originally, so God bless Darlene Drew, but God bless Laura Hamm even more. Holy cow. Hey, here comes the band. Let's play some tunes. That'll be good. We tuned it at the factory. So this is one of those film scores I couldn't get out of my head. I'll just give you the thumbnail plot. It's not exactly a plot, but it's from the film The Girl with the Pearl Earring, which I think is from 2003, if I'm not mistaken, based on a famous novel of the same name. And but the idea is it kind of moves into the personal life of the painter Johannes Vermeer. And so I kind of created this video out of his art, which is, God, they're beautiful quality art on, you know, places like WikiArt and all these things where you can just kind of like, okay, use it, no problem. Don't do anything bad. Don't make too much money. But in any case, the video of this, which starts a little while after the beginning, is all based on his art. And interestingly enough, he died in his early 40s. And did not paint that much. I mean, he painted a lot for somebody who died when they were like 42 or whatever, but there are a very limited number of paintings by Vermeer, and I would say maybe half of them are in this film. So, Girl with the Pearl Earring. Two bars of three. One, two, three, one, two, three. Thank you.
This is that video that I mentioned with the walls of the underpass. So we are, some of this music is on the track, so we hope to hit a balance.
Thank you.
Sarah Allen, Laura Hamm, holy cow. That was an epic. I have to ask how we doing on time here. We have many songs, but some of them are short. That's a good thing. Should we just cut to the chase, or I'm asking Steve, actually. I know he's up there. Plow ahead. Okay, good. This is a really old piece that I wrote. It's very, I like it a lot, you know. James plays the pants off of it. It's just simply called Waltz. Thank you, James Sanders, Leandro Lopez Varady. Now I'm into all the old tunes, but this is also from that same era. This is a little more upbeat and kind of bluesy, whatever. It's called the Pan American Shuffle.
blow your brains out. Ready? One, two, a one, two, three, four.
Thank you.
We get extra money for that? Sorry. Thank you. This next one does have a video. The next two, actually. First one is a mere wisp. I guess we have to get the projector back in the saddle. Quick, Doug, tell a joke. No. Thank you so much for coming. This has been so fun. Holy cow. Okay. This is what it says, autumn, 44 degrees north. We have a power failure. 44 degrees north, or whatever it is, 41 degrees north, 88 degrees west. That's here, in case you were wondering. Kind of like the west suburbs where I live. And you get it. It's really straightforward. I probably didn't have to announce it, so. Should we go to Ireland in purple too? It's good for us to run this with this music, with the video, so that we have another crack at it. This next piece, that is. So you're going to hit go when I'm going to count two bars. Two, one, two, and we'll all start together. Yeah, first movement. Airs, no jigs. This is called jigs and airs, and they're actually backwards. The airs are first and the jigs are second, but airs and jigs just doesn't sound very good, does it? Jigs and airs sounds better. And, you know, people can figure out which is which, right?
Maybe not.
Are we all ready?
Just give me a second. Okay. No, we have piano.
we have piano logistics. We have a piano logistics deal going here, which I approve of. It's good. We need it. If it's not going to work, let's just play the damn thing and get out of here. All right, we're going to go and play the jigs and airs. I'll still count two.
Two bars, that is.
Thank you.
Laura Hamm, James Sanders, Michael Levin, Leandro Lopez Varady, Sarah Allen. I'm Doug Lofstrom. Thank you so much. A fabulous evening, a fabulous audience. I'll stand up too.
Doug Lofstrom and the New Quartet. Thus ends your world tour with the Doug Lofstrom and the New Quartet.